go. Light flashing. Ready. Racing. Star Align actually the first to hit the ground from Comes a Time, Watch Me Dance, and God Has Chosen up nice and prominent through the first 200. Start the Friar is next, and Floyd Ease is back for Louis. Over on the inside is Double Digit. Son of Backer settling down last of all as Star Align leads with his ears pricked. To the riverside they go, less than 1,100 to travel, and Star Align, who's chewing the steel in front, leads the way from the favourite Comes a Time. They're two lengths clear from God Has Chosen, racing on the inside of the mare, Watch Me Dance. A further 2.5, then Double Digit over on the inside. Start the Friar is wider out than Floyd, and back last is Son of Bacchus, about 6 from the leader. At the 700 they go, making play Star Align. He's travelled very easily here in front, equally so. The same could be said for Comes a Time. Star Align given a little more rein, draws a length and a half clear of it. There's still a length and a half. God Has Chosen, no change at all to the order. On the move now though, Watch Me Dance, followed further back Double Digit, Son of Bacchus, and then Floyd, and Start the Friar relegated to last. Star Align headed for home. Comes a Time, got square with it. Watch Me Dance tries to haul them in. A rails run coming for God Has Chosen. Comes a Time, hits the front from Star Align, who's going to fight back. Star Align, Comes a Time, Comes a Time, Star Align, Star Align, Comes a Time. It sounds poetic, doesn't it? But they hit the line, and Star Align, Star Align might have just won it from Comes a Time in a ding-dong go. Not really sure. Thought it might have been Star Align, a breath. In behind them, God Has Chosen, Watch Me Dance, followed by Double Digit. Then came Floyd, next home, Son of Bacchus, and Start the Friar. Star Align, number six. Number six has got it, Star Align. From five, Comes a Time. Had a real ring to it. Star Align, Holly Watson for the Pete Ferdy Stable. Beats Comes a Time after a ding-dong desperate battle. Watch Me Dance, third from God Has Chosen in 125.29. They just cantered around there over the 1,400. It was an almighty sprint from the corner. Comes a Time heading Star Align, but one sense that it always had something left in reserve, and it has come back, regained the lead. The heads were bobbing out of sync, but it was Star Align's that has made it to the post in the nick of time. Over Comes a Time, Watch Me Dance. Short head, one length in 125.29, 34.83 the last 600. The winner by Universal Ruler from Lenorney for D. Martin, A. Ingalls, P. Jackson, B. Armstrong, G. Bowden, L. Chapman, M. J. Armstrong, trained by Pete Fernie at Cambana Lodge and ridden by Holly Watson. Comes a Time by Sessions from Let's Go. Craig Fox, A. Stecco, the owners. Prepared by Michael Grantham. Ridden by Chris Parnham. And for Watch Me Dance by I'm All The Talk from Coventry to Rio. Steve Wolf, Peter Nucky. And a great battle here between these two. Young Holly Watson finding that little bit extra out of Star Align. And being able to come back, rally, and beat Comes a Time. We go to the next event, race 7, the first of two 2,400 metre races today. One, He's a Parker, and 13, Frequent Fryer, the scratchings there. Chris Parnham will ride number 4, Picture Perfect, and Brandon Louis onto 11 in Final Chill. There was something very poetic about the finish of race number 6, Britt.
Indeed, a very close finish there. Holly Watson's cap looked like it come over her eyes. I don't even know if she was able to see where she was going. Pete Fernie joins me now. Pete, second up here today. What did you make of the first start run, and then how has this horse been in the 3 weeks since?
Yeah, he's been really good. He's a lovely horse, and he just tries. When that horse joined him, I thought he'll still kick because he really tries hard. And it was 3 weeks between runs, but the first one took a little bit out of him. It was a really good run first up, but we're really happy. We'll have to get George Grulicic to buy a new cap because she couldn't see coming over her eyes. So, George, you'll have to buy a new cap.
What happened if the elastic sort of went? It looks like it is a few years old, just having a look at Holly coming back into scale now.
We might have to go to George's piggy bank and buy a new one.
Well, I think there might be plenty there, hopefully, to find a new cap, that is for sure. You mentioned that the horse, the improvement from that first up run to now, and having felt that first up run, you elected not to trial. The reason for that?
Oh, in Kalgoorlie, there's no trial, so I don't trial many of them. The older horses know how to race and just got to try and get them fit enough in the track.
This is one that you'll just continue to travel from Kalgoorlie to Perth and not leave in Luke's stable?
I'll most probably put him into Luke's name now. He can have him from now on. So I just don't want to travel him anymore. So Luke can have him from here on in.
How about Luke? Did you see this one? He's sporting a bit of a rip in his pants. What's happened there?
Yeah, we're not tailors. We're not travelling that well. We can't have all these flash clothes like yous do.
Well, I think after the win of Star Align, maybe you could buy him some new pants. How about that?
He was going to wear a pair of Lockies because I reckon Lockies put on a bit of weight, so it's all right.
He might need to get a few sizes bigger, I would dare say. Well done.
Thanks, Britt.
There is Peter Fernie. Over to Holly Watson.
Well, Holly Watson, we were just talking about that cap. Talk us through what happened there and whether or not you needed a nose roll because you got your head up quite a lot in the home straight.
Oh, definitely. I think I needed a nose roll at that point. I was flicking my head up trying to get it out of my eyes. So, yeah, definitely didn't help my steering.
Just, can we show the camera there, the cap itself? It looks, may have seen better days.
I'd say so.
And what about this horse? He fought back really strongly because it looked like to us you got headed by Comes a Time.
Yeah, he did. I just wanted to hold on to him that bit longer and balance him up around the corner because he was hanging off the track. But once he got headed by that other horse, he fought back really strongly. So he was really nice today.
Looked like the kind of horse that a mile wouldn't worry either.
No, definitely not.
Congratulations, well done.
Thank you.
There is Holly Watson and Peter Fernie combined with Star Align, who takes out race number 6.